Hello everybody, in this video we are gonna prove the boundedness theorem. So without any further ado, let's get started. And yeah, please subscribe to make sure your maths teacher never gets mad at you. Starting off with a statement, let I be a closed bounded interval. A closed bounded interval is an interval with its endpoints included in it. And both of its endpoints are real numbers. So I is such an interval. Also, let f be a continuous function on I, where f is defined from I to the set of real numbers. Considering these two conditions, we prove that f is bounded on I. So that's the statement of boundedness theorem. Now let's move towards its proof. To start off the proof, we suppose f is defined and continuous on a closed interval I, and we also take a contradiction that f is not bounded on I, which means f is unbounded on I, obviously. To understand unboundedness of a function, we need to understand the boundedness of a function first. A function f is said to be bounded on an interval I if there exists a real number m such that mod of f of x n is less than or equal to m, which means that the mod of the of all the images of the function f of x are less than or equal to a real number m. One thing I want to tell you here is a function is bounded if it is both bounded above and bounded below, and the bounded function I described here is basically bounded above, because we just need to negate the boundedness of function. So if we negate that a function is not bounded above, it is enough for it to be called as unbounded function. You might not get it now, but let's move to the next slide and I will explain you every single thing. As we know that the function f of x is not bounded, this means that for some n belongs to real numbers, the absolute of the images of f of x are greater than that real number n. So basically we are negating the condition for a bounded function here. Now we recall that a bounded interval is a bounded sequence. As the interval I is bounded, this implies that I is also a bounded sequence, and we call that sequence x and its values xn, but they are basically all the values of the interval I. We did all of this just to use the Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem to proceed further in the proof. So what the Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem says? Every bounded sequence in Rn has a convergent subsequence. This implies that the sequence x, which is bounded, also has a subsequence x dash that converges to a number x. Also, we call the elements of subsequence x dash as xn subscript r, as they are basically the elements of xn. Using another theorem for limits, which states if x is a convergent sequence and the values of x belongs to a closed interval, then the limit of that convergent sequence also belongs to that closed interval. Now, as I is a closed interval and the elements of our subsequence x dash also belongs to the closed interval I, so by the theorem stated here, the limit of x dash also belongs to I, and the limit of x dash is a small x, so the small x belongs to I. Since f is continuous on I, this means that f is continuous on all the elements of I. So this implies that f is also continuous on small x, as small x is also an element of I. Now look at the definition of the continuity of a real function. A function f from real number or a subset of real number to real number is said to be continuous at a point x that belongs to the domain of f if whenever xn is a real sequence converging to x, the sequence f of xn converges to f of x. Now let's see how we will apply this on our proof. By definition of continuity, we have established that f of xn converges to f of x. We also know that the limit of a sequence is always unique. So this shows that the limit of f of xn subscript r is also f of x. Using another theorem of limits, every convergent sequence is bounded. We can say that the function f of xn r, which is a convergent sequence, must be a bounded sequence. But hey, this leads us to a contradiction, as we have assumed in the very start of the proof that the absolute of all the images of fxn are greater than some real number n. So the absolute of images of f of xn subscript r must be greater than some nr or r for our convenience. But now, as we have proved that f of xn r is a bounded sequence, we have obtained that f is not unbounded on the closed bounded interval I. So that's it for the proof. Please subscribe and share this video with your friends. I will see you all in my next one. Till then, bye.